Bodega Boys.
Tonight, in exclusive late breaking news, audio tapes have come out regarding the Trump wall scandal. Steve Bannon and Donald Trump apparently were on the phone discussing how to start the scam. This is unverified audio tape of the president discussing how to scam Americans. You've heard it here first at Fox 419, the home of the Seattle Superhawks. Trump 2020, motherfuckers. We'll cut to the audio tape right now.
So listen, right? So what we're going to do is, we say we're going to build a wall, right? We build a wall on the border of Mexico. These people don't like Mexicans. So I'm going to do, well, this is what I'm going to do, Steve. Listen, listen. No. You listen to me. Listen. We build the wall. We say we're going to build a wall, right? We start a website. It's going to be great. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be the most amazing website. It's going to be have so much flash. It's going to crash your browser. You can only use it on Chrome. We have a fundraiser, right? We raise funds for the wall. But guess what? We do what they call a MSM, a multi-scheme marketing. We scheme and we market. And then we put the wall on the back burner. And then we use the money and we go play golf at Mar-a-Lago. How do you feel about that? What do you think? Eh? Great idea. I love it. Listen, we cannot let this leak. If somebody is taping this or if this comes out, we're fucked. Actually, no, we're not. I can shoot somebody on Fifth Avenue and be fine. But you know what? Let's discuss this further on a secure line because I'm on Ben Carson's burner phone right now, and I don't know what he's been doing on it. So I'm going to go now. I'm going to call you back from the red phone in the special room. Okay? This is episode 216 of the Bodega Boys podcast. Trumpito out. The eagle has landed. The eagle has landed. Episode 216. Do the drop. Do the drop. Do it now. Bannon, I'll contact you later.
You're listening to The Audio Art, the most dangerous podcast in the universe. Do the drop.
Fucking vibes. Episode 216 of the world's most what's the adjective for this week? The world's most luxurious podcast. That's right.
Erudite.
Okay. Well, we look at the bang. You know what I'm saying? All right. We've got the swoop. We got the good hair.
You know what I'm saying?
Yo, as always, brought to you from Cash App. You know, brought to you by Cash App. Excuse me. Cash App. The Cash App pays you back. That's not actually their jingle, but you know that'll work for now.
You make money making jingles. That's how you make money now. Pusha T is rich forever off the McDonald's jingle.
Rich forever.
He don't got to
like John Legend, like John Legend and Rick Ross would say. They're gonna be rich forever. Yo, as always, shout out to number one show in the late night Showtime, Desus and Mero. You know what I'm saying? Still out there Monday, Sunday nights and Thursday.
Sunday. You know what I'm saying?
You know. And also, we have the virtual tour going. Shout out to everyone that's taking part of the virtual tour. We've done two of them already. Wow. They've been fire. Sometimes there's a little technical difficulty, but we fought through it. Shout out to everyone that was in the meet and greet, had a good time. Everyone that went said they had a wonderful time. People were saying we should do more of them. Maybe we'll do more of them. But you know what? There's still tickets available at bodegahive.com. So don't miss out. Don't get FOMO.
You know what I mean? Don't do that.
Don't get FOMO.
You'll feel horrible. You know what I'm saying? When you read those tweets or when you see the retweet of like, yo, my microphone turned off, but they were so cool, man. They were like texting me while we were in the chat. It was awesome. Mm-hmm. I had a great time. Mm-hmm. You're going to feel like a dick. Don't feel like a dick.
You're going to feel sad.
You know what I'm saying?
You want to feel like a dick?
No.
Feel like a dick. Is there any other time, a good time to feel like a dick?
If you predicted something bad was going to happen and then it doesn't happen and then you feel like a dick, that's a good time to feel like a dick.
That's true. That's
you
true.
Know what I'm saying? Like, yo, like, damn, the Red Sox are definitely going to beat the Yankees. And then you're like, and then they don't, and you're like, I feel like a dick because I bet on that, but it didn't happen. So
I thought you said
like a dick.
You said something bad. You thought something was bad was gonna happen, and it doesn't happen. And I thought you were talking about like, yo, ISIS is gonna blow up something in Times Square. But you were like, nah, a little lower, a little smaller. I was like, yeah. I was like, yeah, they didn't,
but
you know? Just like, yo, no, just letting you know, bro. Keep your head on a swivel, you know. Oh,
you know what I'm saying. Listen, and that what brought that to mind was is that baseball is in shambles, as are all sports.
That's true, because didn't the Mets-Yankees game got canceled?
Yeah, because Mets got a couple of Mets got the Rona. I don't know exactly who, but...
Probably the Dominican players.
We knew it was going to happen.
It's Robinson Cano. You think Robinson Cano got it?
No.
You think Robinson... I think Robinson Cano...
And that's the thing. If you live in DR for too long, you've already caught every highly contagious virus. You know what I'm saying? Like from dengue to malaria to motherfucking, what was this shit called? Zika. That makes your baby.
Oh, wow. Small. Zika's a throwback.
Remember Zika? Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Remember Zika? Yeah. That was not a pandemic. That was like a flash in the pandemic. You know what I'm saying? Like, but it had a moment. You know what I'm saying? I think if it didn't make your baby's head small, people wouldn't care about Zika.
That's true. Are there any Zika babies? Well, no, that wasn't that low. I was going to be like, any Zika babies teenagers now? Call us up. Hit us up. If you are a grown Zika baby, hit us up at 917-540-8971 and tell us how your little head life went.
Yo, who's telling us a text and a flick?
Versus just every time they pass by a new era, they're like, damn.
Yo, damn. Yo, I got a size 2?
No. That's not an adult size. Get out of here, baby head.
Yo.
Oh.
It's like two niggas that listen to us who's thinking like, yo, sorry.
That's fucked up.
Y'all niggas ain't have to go there.
Instead of using both earbuds, they just have one earbud in front of them, like a TV.
That's their Bluetooth speaker?
Yep.
Yeah!
These little Zika big head, little head babies. Little Zika head babies.
Baby, little Zika head.
Got the little swan noggin. Bony goes little, that's the next single. Little Zika baby. Little Zika, little head Zika baby. From Bony Goats. But it's an inspirational song about how the baby triumphs.
How he got a head.
Yeah. That's it. How he got a head in America. It's a reboot. Main character, Little Zeke Baby.
Little Zeke Baby.
Oh.
Yo, all right.
We've been wilding with the Zika Baby.
You gotta do a buddy cop movie with the dude with that cartoon from MTV where homie had the wild brolic dome. Remember that shit? Ooh,
shit.
Fuck.
Damn.
Was it I think it was called The Head. Shout out to Google.
Oh wow, yeah. Whoa, throwback. 94.
Yeah, that was what MTV had, like animation. They had like the Eon Flux and fucking that shit. And then there was and Beavis and Butthead, and then there was one other show that I cannot remember.
Well, I mean, what does MTV have now then, bro? What are you trying to say? Are you trying to say, hours of ridiculousness isn't enough for you?
Listen, I like Rob Dyrdek as much as the next guy. You know what I'm saying? But yo, I can only see him prance around on stage on his tippy toes, like making like a ooh face for like, you know, half an hour, 45 minutes. You know what I'm saying?
That's a lot longer than I can. Man, listen.
I can't do it sober.
That's true. I think that's when most viewers watch it. Also, remember we asked to be on that show? They were like, no?
No, you can't. But the head of marketing for
Viacom West could be on it?
Yeah, like...
What? Yeah, all right. Okay. Like, all right. All right.
It's a fraud. It's a fraud.
Anyway, we are not bitter. We no longer, you know, we don't worry about the past. The past is the past, baby. We just moving forward. Moving forward, that's why we got a book now. You know what I'm saying? Remember?
Right.
God-level knowledge darts, life lessons. From the BX.
Pre-order it, whatever order status it is right now on your local websites. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
It doesn't have to be Amazon. It could be an actual bookstore, independent bookstore. I suggest you could do that there as well.
There's a couple of bookstores I suggest. Lit Bar in Mott Haven, that's a good one. And then if you put this in your CD-ROM, www.cannabis.com.
That's not a bookstore.
That's not hip-hop, real hip-hop. Hip-hop. Yo, shout out to, whatever happened to all the singing hip-hop groups? Like, Product GAB.
Yo.
GMB, remember? Yeah.
Yo.
Every day I'm living. Oh.
Yo.
Every day I'm living my thug life. What you want me to do? They had joints, bro. They had joints.
It was wild because I'm like, yo, why did y'all, what kind of name was that? Like, the Product G, it sounds like some wild, like, illicit drug, like what the fuck?
Product GAB. I think they were brothers.
Yo, just use your names, dog. Like,
Project G and B.
It's like Gabe and Brian.
They were also known as Money Harm.
Money Harm. Okay, I guess Prodigy and B is a better name.
Doesn't really explain why they were called Prodigy and B, but
their names are like fucking Daryl and James. Their names
are Sincere Guano and Marvin Moore Hugh. So, you know.
There's no G's or B's there. Okay.
No G's.
All
right. Things were different back then. Things were different. You didn't need to have a reason to name a group something.
Like, it was fucking.
But remember this banger they had?
Yeah. Oh. Shit in the middle.
Come on, let's get done. We gotta get it. This is hip hop right here. Listen, I'm singing. Feeling the beat. Going my way. If I ain't a thug, why do I feel this way? If I ain't a thug, why do I feel this way? Why does crime stay on my mind? That's beautiful. That was someone's wedding vows in 2000, okay? One of your parents said that in the community center in Eat a World Projects. Facts. And then they went home and made love and made you. And mm-hmm. then daddy left. Because you know what? He got what he wanted.
He got what he wanted. With that fucking... Shout out to them. Because they birthed Tim Vocals, you know what I'm saying? Who was our national New York treasure, you know what I'm saying?
Listen, singing violent lyrics will always be good.
Yo,
always.
It can't be it. It's like
it's very,
look.
It's super American. Think about the national anthem.
Come on.
The rockets, red glare.
Guns and shit, rockets and busting guns and muskets and shit and racist shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's what's all about.
If you think, also, I guess back in the day, you could sing the national anthem in front of English people's faces, like a diss song. Like, you'd be like, Rockets, red glare. Y'all lost the scoreboard. Scoreboard.
Y'all niggas mad buns. Y'all got a king. Y'all wild
pussy.
Wait.
You got to wait for the dock. You got to wait at the dock for the boat to come in and shit. You're like, yo, the British is coming. Let's roast them niggas. That's where the term, when Paul Revere was like, the British is coming. It was to tell people to get their shit together, put on their old colonial times Timberlands, and get down to the dock. And then when the boat pulled up, they were like, yo, Britain sucks wild dick. Yo,
y'all wild ass in Britain.
Yo, y'all suck.
Oh, you like niggas. Tea? Y'all like getting tea bagged? Word. That's what I heard.
They be sipping Lipton. Yo, get out of here. Go drink some sleepy time. Yo, look at y'all.
Dick. You know what I'm saying? Go eat a biscuit, nigga.
Yo, look at you. Yo, Big Ben ain't even that big. Yo, we got corn over here.
Yo,
you know
my Jacob face bigger than your Big Ben shit. Nigga, fuck out of here.
Get these guys out of here. Yo, does that boat even come with leather? Huh? Huh?
Oh, wow. You don't even got the contrast stitching on the Mayflower.
Yo, what's the difference? Yo, what's the difference between the Nina and the Pinta? About $100,000, motherfucker. Beat it. It's like, oh, wow.
Damn. Yeah, wow. Big hope energy. That's not the energy Hov is on now, though. Now Hov is just like, hey, guys.
Yeah.
Lift yourself up by your bootstraps.
Listen. People are shocked, but most black people, when they become successful, if they were like poor, they get on that shit.
Like, Steve Harvey's been divorced 8 times and has like 4 relationship advice books. Like,
listen. All I'm saying.
Are you kidding me?
And don't shoot me for saying this. Well, you see Hov and Bay at that Republican convention sometime in the future? Ooh.
He's like, no, we're doing a deal. You know what I'm saying?
And then
Republicans.
Jay's going to have on the wild cowboy hat that all the older black Republican guys wear. You know the hat.
Sheriff Duncan hat?
Yeah. Oh, God.
The Stephen A. Smith Cowboys game hat?
Beyonce's going to have it, but it's going to be like cow print. It's just going to be a mess. Just going to
be
a fucking mess.
And shit, like, mad bejeweled and shit. Like, no. Because
he was saying that, like, yo, Black Twitter, what do you, do you get paid when Jack gets paid? Because he's like, yo, why y'all? But then, you know, like, people were just like, oh, Jay-Z's trying to help us. Jay-Z's like saying, like, yo, you guys got to recognize what you bring to the table and everything. Or I'd like to point out that Black Twitter is so disgusted with Jay's behavior after he cheated on Beyonce that they now refer to Jay-Z as her husband and they crop him out of photos. So maybe that's why he hates Black Twitter. Okay? Maybe because every time you mention Jay-Z, Black Twitter just pounces on him. So
listen, Stan Twitter is real, B. And unfortunately, Jay-Z stans are like, you know, hanging out in front of bodegas and sitting on barbershops waiting for their cut. You know what I'm saying? That's true. On social media.
But listen, don't get it twisted. I still would take outdoor social distance dinner with Jay-Z over $2 billion cash up front.
Or LLC? Would you take dinner with Jay-Z or an LLC?
I wouldn't take an LLC, but if there was an S-Corp, now you're talking. Now you're talking. I mean an S-Corp set up by like a real accountant and lawyer, not some legal Zoom shit. Yeah, you know what I'm saying, bro? You getting your financial life together by like people who advertise during Judge Mathis? I mean, that's not safe, bro. Like, they're your acting financial agent, but are they really acting on your behalf? I mean, they open your mail and just forward it to you, bro. No, if you have an account, if you have a corporation through LegalZoom, I remember I had it before. No, it's not good. Because what happens is, like, if you get, like, a tax notice from the government, they call you. They're like, yo, my man, you might want to handle this. I'll just get your mail, Playboy. This is for you. Okay?
They're like,
by the way, you see that part where you was like, that we're party? No. We're different. Listen, we over here, baby. We just get your mail. So like,
no, but you like my accountant, but
first of all, I need you to lower your voice.
No, you're my accountant.
And you need to lower your voice. I don't want anyone seeing you talking to me because they don't want to get the wrong idea. Like, I don't even bang with you like that, my man.
I'm all my financial information.
I don't even know my social.
I call you to get my social.
Fam, listen. You know why it's called LegalZoom? Because legally, I can zoom out this bitch at any moment. You know what I'm saying? Like, I need you to recognize that, okay? I'm doing you a solid right now.
Wow.
So, like, listen. Also, I don't really know law, so you might be in trouble. I don't know if your corporations are set up, but here's like, a stamp for the papers. And here's 100 shares of stock in your company. I don't know what the fuck you're going to do with them, but...
Wow.
Yeah, okay. I guess...
So, what you mean to tell me is that your banner ad on Spank Bang... was not a wise choice for me to click on? Is that what you're
saying? I mean, you out here clicking on ads on a porno site, like, that's some savage behavior.
Listen,
like, you're not running an ad blocker?
I mean, why would I? They could be important ads. You know what I'm saying? What if I want to extend my penis by 7 inches using this one miracle trick?
You know what I'm saying?
That's useful information.
Relax.
Yo, why is that every porn ad? Yo, make your dick 12 inches by this one secret trick that we're going to teach you if you click through all these ads.
All those porn ads are so weird because the one that's just like, yo, make your cum thicker. And you're like, why?
Why would I want that? Why would she want that?
Why are we out here spraying Dannon? Like, nah, nigga.
No.
I'm not trying to bust out some Yoplait.
No.
Like, nobody wants that consistency.
Fam, I clean up so much Danimals off the floor and shit. I don't want my cum to be thicker, dog. I would love for my cum to come out like Gatorade. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, just like mad clear, full of electrolytes.
Oh, the white Gatorade, right?
the Glacier Freeze.
Listen. Oh, listen, if you hung over in the morning, you know how good that one is.
That cherry shit, yeah.
Slam a little Gatorade, shake your head around, and go to work. No one needs to know what you did at night, all right? Listen. They're like, you smell like gin, and you're like, well, you're standing too fucking close. How about that?
I'd be like, who's gin?
Who's gin?
Why do I smell like him? Huh?
Nothing's better than when you're at the point where you hate a job. And you want them to fire you, but you know there's no chance of them firing you, so you just don't give a fuck anymore. I remember my office job when I reached that point because I was trying to get unemployment insurance because I thought unemployment was equal to whatever you were making at the job before you got fired. I'll be good. I can survive off that. No.
Ain't wrong.
So I was like coming in the office. I would smoke a blunt, but. Because I was trying to be careful, I would smoke it outside the Metro North train station. Then I get on the Metro North, stink, reeking of marijuana. Everyone's staring at me, and I'm like, smells like weed in here. Who on this train would smoke marijuana so early?
What?
I'm high, I don't realize it's me. Then I'd be at work, reeking of marijuana. There's no way you could not tell I was high. Just out of control. Not even following the dress code, wearing black jeans, and it's supposed to be like a formal outfit. I'm like, what? Do something then. Fire me.
What you gonna do?
After... I come back from lunch and I had a Limerita tucked under my arm and I just sit at my desk and drink it. Mm. Slurping mad loud, like,
yo, yeah, I'm drunk.
Yeah.
Fight me.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to put my shoes on. I don't want to put
my shoes
on. It's
Limerita o'clock, bro. Bro, I'll schedule a meeting. One time I scheduled a meeting in the conference room just so I could lay on the floor and take a nap by myself. Good times, man. Good times. Wildin'. I hated that job. Y'all know what job I'm talking about. But listen. Anyway.
Yo, when you know you can't get, or when you want to get fired, or you know you can't get fired from a job, you do very ballsy shit. You know what I'm saying?
But there's a difference between, you can't get fired because you have a skill that they can't replace, or you can't get fired because this place is just so inept that they don't even know you're fucking up. Yep. And they're still busting your ball. And I'm like, fam, we're not doing anything. We don't create anything here.
We're all taking L's.
Yeah, exactly. That was the attitude. It was like, yeah, your L is not bigger than mine. We're all in this together, okay?
There's L quality across the board over here, okay? All right? That was like the pep rally talk in the conference room. Like, yo, L quality. We all trash.
One day I just took four coworkers, and it was 1 o'clock, and I was like, I'm done today. Y'all want to come with me to a bar? And it was like, you're just not going to come back? I was like, if we all leave, they can't question where we all went. And it was like, oh, shit, you're right. And we just all left. We went to some Mexican restaurant, 42nd Street, and got fucking ripped. And they were like, we're going to get in trouble tomorrow. And I was like, watch, when we come in tomorrow, no one's going to know we left. No one knew we left. Mm-mm-mm.
Bro, when you're working, that's the beauty of corporate America. Sometimes you work for places that are so huge, or huge and inept, that you could just fucking just put a cardboard cutout at your desk for a month, and nobody would even notice. You know what I'm saying? That was the wildest shit. Like Lehman Brothers was like that too, bro. That was I've heard of places being understaffed. I've never seen somewhere so overstaffed with this motherfucker sitting around just collecting checks. I was just like, bro, what am I doing here? I'm doing 2 hours of work a day, but I'm here for 8 hours. What am I doing besides smoking Mad Newports?
I remember at that job. It's what you're talking about being too overstaffed. There was a lady, and she had been at the company for 30 years. Every time I saw her, she would just walk by my desk with a teapot. And she'd be like, hey, baby. And I was like, what do you do? and then I wanted to find out. I was like, she's older. She probably should have retired already. What's she doing? Her cubicle had doilies in it. And she would knit and stuff. And then one day I went there, she was just watching. She had just started Game of Thrones or some shit. So she was spending the day watching Game of Thrones. So I'm what the f- is she related to the owner? And they was like, no, she worked with the company for so long. They feel that a sense of loyalty to her. So they don't want to throw her. They don't want to fire her. So they just kept her on the payroll. Damn. I was like, excuse me? I was like, y'all just keeping niggas on payroll? What? I didn't even get paid last week.
Yeah. Meanwhile, she got her $28,000 weekly check.
Uh-huh.
And was like, oh, the red wedding. God damn.
They killing niggas left and right. She's just leaving at 3 o'clock to go play tennis. I'm like, what the fuck is going on here?
She's like, yo, I'm going to church. And they're like, yo, it's Tuesday.
She's like, listen. I was going to church. I didn't say I was going to church in America. Bye. With your broke ass. I'm like, oh, shit. Yo, she got a PJ.
Yo, what the fuck?
Yo. Also, shout out to Megan Thee Stallion. We're sending Susio love and support to her. She got bucked in the feet by
the
menace from Brampton. Okay?
You know the fucking vibes.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
Listen, Tory. It's coming. Yo. It's coming. Listen.
Yo, listen, man.
How you really shoot somebody?
Yeah, also, I don't know Tory Lane's origin story, but I believe that he began as a singer, like an R&B singer, not a rapper. He just kind of fell into rap. So I'm like, you're a singing ass motherfucker. You're 4'11". Why would you be running around with a gun? Isn't that what security's for? Because they know I'm not just gonna pull out a gun and shoot for no reason.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's just mad dumb.
To be fair, you gotta pay extra money for security.
Yeah, but it's in this situation it would have been worth the cost.
Running around, going for people. Because, it's if you just go into the supermarket. If you had to pay to have security with you every time you went to the supermarket, you go broke. So there's certain situations, you just bring the burner, just in case. But this was not a just-in-case situation. A just-in-case situation is if, niggas try to pop smoke you. You know what I'm saying? If some shit like that happens, you can't, you just shooting a girl in the feet? Like, I, that's weird. Yeah. I, like, none of my boys have ever shot one of the, like,
I don't know any niggas that have shot women, period. Like, like, or shit.
I do. But that's different. That's like an aggression. Like, there was things were involved. And it was like a kind of one of those situations where everybody knew their role. It wasn't like an innocent bystander or whatever.
Oh,
like,
no. I seen a woman shoot another woman on some gang relationship, but not like a dude just pull up like, yo, give me your number. Nah. Fuck that. Pow! Nah. I was wild. Like, yo, bro, that's even in the hood is hood. Like, motherfuckers, hood. That's like the super basicest, like, fucking life lesson. Like, dog.
But also, just, like, if you hanging out with someone one day, it's gotta take a lot for you to shoot them. Like I've never had a moment where I'm like, yo, today I'm gonna shoot Mero. You know what? Had enough. I have had enough. And then it was just like
clap this one.
Mero, can I talk to you? Like, no. Like,
hey, well, yo, what was that? Why are you chambering around?
Oh, it's like, you want to edit shit in the script? It's like, no. Matter of fact, we should do that. We should bring guns to the office when the office restarts just to make the staff a little nervous.
Yeah, nah. I mean, that's what I would do. That was my plan, actually, coming in, was just to not say nothing and just put it on the table when the meeting starts.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
you know how
niggas put their phone on the table and shit? Like, mm-hmm. Put the gun on the table, keep your phone in your lap.
What we're going to do at the next meeting, every writer, when they're pitching ideas, when we go back in the office, we're going to write each writer's name on a bullet.
Mm.
And if you pitch a bad idea, we put the bullet into the 4-5 and we play a little game of Russian roulette.
Ooh. So.
Also, that could be the code open. So, you know, it's like, how much do you believe in this sketch? Huh? Huh? You willing to die for the sketch?
Huh?
It's like, not like
you going to,
it's like, yeah. They're like, I'm sure this is definitely against like WAG regulations. I was like, or
yeah.
Now we snitching?
I'm contacting,
are we snitching?
Immediately. I'm contacting my union rep. I don't know that I'm supposed to be shot over a mediocre sketch.
Also, you know, I actually just got a text from Showtime that I have to drop the problematic light after that.
Nah,
apparently now in America you can't threaten your workers. Wow.
You know what? It's a private corporation. You know what I'm saying? We'd have to subscribe to federal law.
Also, they were just like, hey, guys, you guys are Viacom, CBS, and we really are trying to lay low right now. So right now, Viacom and CBS is a person that cheated on their wife, but it was like high profile, and now they're just laying low.
Nigga, Viacom and CBS is Larry Davis. Hiding in apartment 4B. Like, yo, are they outside still?
You know what they're not? They're not streaming. That's right. Be sure to pick up the new BET Plus app and the new MTV Plus app and a new Bravo, whatever app, the CBS app, the Showtime app, Bodega TV app. We're coming out with that. So that has nothing to do with us. It just shows you security camera from Bodegas. I don't know if that's something you want to watch.
Also that, the Pattern app, you know what I'm saying? Tracy Ellis Ross and Victor have collaborated on their hair line, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful. Constant. It's amazing.
It gives you music to detangle to if you attach it to your Spotify.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, amazing, it detangles to the beat. You know what I'm saying? Like, throw some Solange, nigga, get to work.
You're like, oh, you know what? Today I'm feeling like an indie detangle. You're like, ooh. Have you heard of Khaled? And it's like, oh, shit. Oh,
wow.
That's right.
You say Khaled, and then DJ Khaled comes on by accident, like, we don't pass!
You're like, oh, stop! You're hurting my curls! You're hurting my curls! Your curls are all dropped now? Like,
yo,
oh,
they just like,
you scared my curls! Where my curls at? For the front to back, and where my curls at? Tracy, you put us in an ad. We'll sing that.
Yo, let's do it.
Cause curls just wanna have fun. Curls just wanna have fun. We're just hopping around. They're like, this is so confusing.
This is bizarre. They don't even have hair.
Like, they're like, why isn't even Victor in this commercial? This is wild.
Is this like, why putting it in Victor's hair? Like, we're just like massaging Victor's scalp.
This shit.
The commercial was us having a bubble fight with Vic Mensa, and everyone was like, "What?
This is bizarre."
What?
And at the end, it just ends with Vic Mensa looking directly in the camera, like, "Fuck academics."
2020, motherfucker.
But Tracy's too nice to say no for it. She's like, "It's I. Thank you guys.
It's cool. Wow. Like, it's really different.
You know, it's got your energy. It's good. You love to see that." Yeah, I'll get back to you. My mother, Diana Ross, is on the phone, so I gotta take that call.
Yeah, bye. Yeah. Also, I don't really like to say, I wouldn't want to say fuck academics. I enjoy learning. I mean,
yeah, yeah, like that's, you know, and so I also used to have a pair of academic jeans back in the day. I got them vintage in Italy.
Yeah.
It was weird.
It was wild. It was a great time. Yeah. I had a 555 Soul hat on, too.
Yeah. Shout out to 555 Soul. People don't forget, 555 Soul was the first piece of clothing that represented real hip hop.
Yeah.
It was.
Facts.
That and a canvas Brooklyn Industries tote bag.
Yo.
That's how you know you loved hip hop, okay?
Yo, if you had the Brooklyn Industries tote bag, yo, you had mad fucking Def Jux CDs in that motherfucker.
Yo. You know the vibes.
And thinking back on that shit now, is it weird that you could find like PNB Nation, like 555 Soul, all those brands at Yellow Rat Bastard?
Yep.
Ooh,
that was like the last place. Thinking back at it now, being older, that was like the last place I'd expect to find it.
Listen, but those were a look. And then I was like, they got Industries in Brooklyn? What the fuck was going on? Oh, I'm in the Bronx. Like, I don't know. That's back then. My knowledge of Brooklyn, all I knew of Brooklyn basically was like, I want to say Crown Heights, because my cousin Mark. They lived over there, so I knew over there, Sterling Street, Presidential Street, all that stuff. And some girl on my block was telling us about some new up-and-coming community called Williamsburg, and they had a restaurant called C, and you could swing in a chair when you got there. We was like, say less. Let's go. Get the burners. Let's go. Niggas is really going to Williamsburg with the burners. Like, yo, what's
yo,
up?
What?
What's up? Getting that drunk man noodles, and I hope don't know why I fuck with me on the way back to the car. It's like, oh, wow. This is not the energy Williamsburg wants.
Yo, I had zero knowledge of Brooklyn, bro, growing up. Like, literally the only knowledge I had, I would go to the gate stop on the J because my cousin lived in Bushwick. That was it. That was the only family member I had in Bushwick. And motherfuckers would go out there, and I was just like, yo, this is like Bronx 2.0, dog. Like, what's going on right here? You know what I'm saying? Like, and it was I feel like at that time, every borough was known for like a certain type of crime. Like if you were uptown, you were hustling. If you were in the Bronx, you know what I'm saying? Like it was like hustling, boosting. It was like a mixture of things. Brooklyn was just like, yo, we're going to rob you, nigga. Like, robberies. Like, yo, I don't care. Yo, you could be 90, you could be 15, you could be a bicycle, nigga. You getting robbed. Like,
getting
at finger point.
Bro.
I was just like, yo, nah, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do graffiti out here.
Oh, man.
I'm not trying to get robbed for a can of paint.
I remember my cousin, he got married, and it was like a big deal because he bought a house. And it was like, ooh.
Oh, hey.
He bought a house in New York. What he failed to tell us, you know what? He probably still lives there, but he definitely don't listen to this podcast. He seemed to have purchased a house in a fictional part of New York that doesn't really exist. It's a fairy tale part that people every now and then pretends is a real place, but it's not. It's like the Atlantis of New York. It's called Canarsie. Like,
whoa, what is that?
Like, I was like, how do I get there? He was like, all right, take the L train to the last stop and I'll meet you in the parking lot and drive you the rest of the way. And I was like, sir, are we going up? Are we doing the Appalachian Trail? What are you talking about?
Sir.
How far away are we going? Do I need to get vaccinated? Do I need to bring a passport? What is going on? Why did I get off the L train and there was border control there? I had to fill out a document and tell them what boroughs I was in before I could get into Canarsie. Why is it like that? Why y'all so far out there?
To get to Canarsie, you got to take the L to the last stop and then walk through the fucking wardrobe that takes you to Narnia. You know what I'm saying?
I was like, yo. And you know, like people forget back in the day. Well, it's probably the same way now. No, it's not the same way now because you got Uber. But back in the day, if you took the train all the way into Brooklyn, you had to make a decision. Are you trying to come home that night or are you spending the night? Because if you're trying to come home tonight, You can't just be on the train at 3 a.m.
No. I was like, yo, I'm not leaving Brooklyn.
We're working on getting the visuals back for the podcast. Because you know what?
Some of y'all been asking at this point,
us not having visual recordings of this is just a disgrace. It's an affront to God. It's like Yeah. It's as if God was like, yo, I want y'all to write the Bible. And niggas was like, nah, you know what? I don't even write. I don't use the pen or the pad. I got it in my mind. What if God told Jay-Z to write the Bible? He was like, nah, chill, son.
I don't write it. I just recite it.
Okay? I'm not a biter. I'm more a writer. Come on. Yo. Every time your Nana wants to go to church, you got to call Jay-Z. Like, what's Ecclesiastes 3:15, Jay? He's like,
she's just a wild old Italian lady.
Like, Jay, what's going on? Jay, could you pray for my Nana? He's like, I don't got time. Let me ask you something. Every time you pray, God gets paid. You still want to do that? I'm like, wow, you want to defund God now? Like,
wow.
Damn, Jay, like, who's coming to the rock brunch now?
Yo.
That would finally be the time we get to go to Rock Nation brunch. Yeah. And you know who pulls up? Jesus.
Yeah.
All right? How you going to feel? How's it going to feel when Jesus shoots up the Rock Nation brunch?
Yo, Jesus and Rush Limbaugh?
Yeah,
they come. You gotta hide behind Rush Limbaugh and shit to like use a nigga as a meat shield.
Yo, don't shoot Rush. Yo, don't shoot. Don't. Oh man, so Rock Nation brunch is done. No, they might actually. Most of the people that who go to the Rock Nation brunch have no problem with. Mm. They don't believe in coronavirus. Let's keep it funky, so they can still have that not brunch. Let me see. If you're
it's caused by 5G, you know what I'm saying? But if you fly on a G5, you can reverse it.
Think about it. Open your third eye. Open your third eye.
That's something. Remember, guys,
here's some more stuff for you guys to overstand. Listen, invest in sleds right now. If you got a kid, buy a sled right now, because once it gets colder, if there's any snow in your area, sleds are going to be sold out. Every toy that people want for inside entertainment, you buy it now, because once it gets cold and people are still got their kids in stores, listen, there's going to be a run on shit. There's already a run on. There's a run on scooters. There's a run on bikes. There's a run on, was it pools? I believe there's a run on pools. There's a run on not bulletproof glass, but just the plexiglass that goes up between registers and restaurants like that. So what I'm saying, bro, if you're trying to cash out, you know, cop, hoard, sell. Okay?
Yo, you know that song? This is a shot in the dark, but maybe you know, because, you know, New Yorkers. That store on Canal that's like strictly plastic. They sell plastic everything.
So, yeah. There's a couple of stores like that, but yeah. There's one in
like, real big one with the yellow sign and the red letters. I'm a visual guy.
Bro, that's like 99% of the stores on Canal Street. Like you're next to be like, yo, bro, it has like Chinese letters on the front. I'm like,
Can you be a little... Mandarin or Cantonese?
He's gonna be like, yeah, bro, got a pull down gate. I'm like, oh, Jesus Christ, Mero. He's like, yeah, bro, come on, the store, okay, you know, it's on Canal Street. It's somewhere between, you know, the 6 line and the 2 train.
And the 2 train.
You know,
I hope that on there, 98. You know,
I hope that narrows it down. It's not in front of Pearl Paint, but it's where Pearl Paint used to be. And like,
you know what I'm saying?
I'm like, what?
What?
Also, shout out to any New Yorker that ever went to Canal Street by the six train. And then we were like, you know what? I could walk. It's no big deal. I'm going to walk to the 2 train. Yeah, no. That is a long-ass walk. There's some walks I've done now that I look back, and I was like, yo, I was bugging. They have a bus right there. Why did I walk this?
Yeah, but
as a real...
You know what I'm saying?
Let's be honest. As real New Yorkers, we look down on the bus. You know it. We all know it. Even those of you who ride the bus, you know when you be on the bus, you be tight. Especially if you're on the bus and people walking on the street are moving faster than you are because of traffic. Then you're just like, what did I do? Why am I here?
The best NYC characters are on the bus and on the subway. Like, but the bus especially. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's been so many times that I was mad that I had a clamshell phone because I was just like, yo, my son is wilding over there, B. Like, you know what I mean? Like, dude's just pissing on the back of the bus, fucking smoking weed, doing all type of wild shit. I'm like, yo, if I had all these videos right now, I could start, like, my own world star or some shit.
Or you can start your own ridiculousness.
That's right.
All right.
Boom!
Take that. Okay.
Yo, holla, R.I.P. Sumner, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
R.I.P. to the God. Sex God.
Listen.
Slip dick till his last breath.
Nothing but respect to...
The original Sucio boy.
Our Sucio leader. Think about
Sucio
all the Sucio
forefather.
Okay. Setting up, looking, look, let's listen. This right now, this episode of Bodega Boys is now the last dance for Sumner Redstone, okay?
Yo, for real.
We are singing the praises, all right? Your man tried to set up the wild Trizzy,
yo,
okay?
You know what I'm saying?
At 92 years old?
Trizz name, 92, okay?
That is the definition of sucio, okay? At his funeral, they're going to be like, sucio mente! Sucio, do 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 mente! Mente! Oh, man.
Yo, he was a sucio boy for real. Yo, it's so ill that, like, fam, I don't even, like, I've seen 92-year-old people, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, clothed. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I don't understand how. And listen, this is ageist. I'm gonna come right out and say it's ageist. I don't got
say
the soundboard in front of me, so you can drop
say
the
with your chest.
Right
say
after.
With your chest.
I'm gonna say with my chest, it's ageist. How the fuck do you put a 92-year-old dick in your mouth? Like,
you know what? You don't think about the inches going in your mouth. You think about the zeros going in your bank account.
True.
That's how you do
that's
it.
That's the only way I can reconcile
it.
I was tossing and turning last night thinking about that. Like, just like, yo, I gotta talk to my guys tomorrow and figure this out because I don't know how I could do it unless it was monetarily motivated.
You wanna hear some more? Let's talk the sucio levels to this guy's life, okay? At 92 years old, he had a 50-year-old living girlfriend.
Woo!
Who said
he's like, yo, she's young for him.
Who said he could do nothing more than do grunt. He could grunt at her. Like, that's how he would respond.
Despite
his rapidly deteriorating condition, he was obsessed with eating steak and demands to the extent that he could be understood to engage in sexual activity every day, even though Dr. Gold has told him to abstain from it. Wait. It gets better. It gets better. Where is it? Hold on. Wait. Yeah, he's... Yeah, that's it. Sorry, I thought it was something else, but no, it doesn't get better. It's just that. You mean? So what they would do? They were at one point they were putting steaks in blenders, allegedly.
Yes.
And give it.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. We're making a movie about this.
Yo,
we tried to make a movie about it before, and they were like, "Do you want to be murdered at 15:15? All right, we make people disappear all the time. We'll have that guy from the cafeteria take you out." I was like, "Oh shit,
yo,
I want a problem."
My man is a wild boy, fam. Like, yo, the quotes are just, like, you don't even need to hear the audio, dog. Like, just the quotes are out of control, be like.
Are these
my
goals?
Man said, what the fuck did, yo.
Are these goals? Is this
Bob's
something?
Bob's never done a threesome with two men. He's done it with three women, so he's a little bit nervous. But he's going to come because I want him to.
Yo, that's a real friend. How many of us have, as I call you, say, real friends, all right?
Yo. So what'll probably happen will probably really excite you. I'll fuck her, and then she'll suck Bob off, and he'll fuck her, and she'll suck me off. Yo, this nigga had a play-by-play? Yo, fam, you got a game plan for smashing? Like, I just drink Henny and go in there.
Nah, he was trying to map it out.
What the fuck?
It was like back in the day when you be in a nightclub and shit, and like dance hall comes on, and you're like grinding with some girl, but she got the wild yeeks, and she controls her hips too much, and she's pushing you back, and then your boy comes back and braces you,
yeah,
to help you, yeah,
he's like, yeah, he's like,
exactly. And then you look back like, yo, thank you, and then you really
yo,
start going to town and shit, yeah. That's this is something that was trying to get that going, bro. That's a real friend. Okay,
he's spotting him. He's like spotting your man at the gym and shit. Like, yo,
we gotta do the wild animation of the guy that, because who was the guy? Sumner Redstone was trying to help. It was his boy. He was just like,
his name was Bob.
Bob.
So then
hi,
I was
guys.
Just like, Bob. And I was just like, you know what? Let me shut up before I get killed by the Mighty Assassins.
We don't need to.
Make sure you're hot.
We don't need to make it hot.
No kink shaming. You know what I'm saying?
We're not kink shaming. We always we never kink shame. We just point out facts.
That's it. If you're 92, you still fucking. That's a fact.
Excuse me. Hi. My name, welcome to the funeral of Sumner Redstone. My name is Bob. They asked me to say a couple of things about my friend Sumner. And I think the best thing I can say to him is, thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a pal and you got my dick sucked.
That's so good.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. If you found out your pop, not your papa, not your father, your grandfather,
yeah,
was out here getting a wild drizzy. Okay, not a drizzy.
Thrizzy.
Does that change how you look at Pop?
With his mans. I'm like, with yo, you get it in like that? Okay.
And then you remember his mans from when you was little. He'd be like, oh, hey, little Mero, how's it going? He's like messing with your hair and shit. Like, he's giving you candy and money. Yeah. He's like, that's crazy. That's Pop's friend. Yeah.
You're like, why was Uncle Bob always mad happy? Yo, don't worry about that.
Don't worry about it. You know what I'm saying? Why'd you always call Uncle Bob the connector? What was that about?
Yo, every time you guys play basketball together, you call yourselves the Eiffel Tower. What's that about?
Yeah, what was that about? That was weird.
Yo!
Why does Uncle Bob have all those weird... Why does Uncle Bob have all those really long, thin metal rods in the back of his car that smell like pee-pee? too far. You went too far. It's like highway to the problematic zone.
Yeah,
that's from Top Gun 3. Did they ever make another Top Gun?
Nah, they can't. They found that Tom Cruise was 5'1" and they couldn't do it.
Damn, he thought that he was Tom Cruise.
But he's coming out with some new shit, I think. I think him and like Julia, it's like a renaissance of like the Wash people. I think there's a Tom Hanks, Julia Roberts, Tom Cruise movie coming out soon, I think.
I can see that. That's big early 2000s vibes.
Big.
You know what I'm saying?
Big.
You know what? I'll go even further. Early 95 vibes.
Hell
right?
Yeah.
Early 90s vibes.
Boot cut vibes. Like, Mud jeans vibes.
Durangos, wearing Durangos to Nell's on 14th Street vibes. But
Jimmy's Bronx Cafe vibe.
Yo. Hey, Mero, I'm going to get off this Nextel. Meet me at the Shark Bar, bro. Yeah, bro.
Yo, I got my Dickie suit on. They're going to let us in the China Club this time. The bouncer told me he would.
Bro, check out my sweater. It's iceberg, but it has Mickey on it. Let's go to Justin's.
Yo, let's go to Justin's. Yo, let's go to Justin's and order $20 macaroni.
Bro, when we're done with Justin, I remember one night I was at Justin's and wow, their fried chicken was so good. This is when Justin was still in New York. Their fried chicken was super good. Tretch was there and I was drinking an amaretto sour because I was learning to relearn how to drink alcohol because I had a terrible experience with the locks at NYC Booms where I was drinking Hennessy and Devil Springs mixed together.
Oh, now you're
can you understand? You understand what that would do to like a 17-year-old or some shit like that? Like I was even of age. I should not have been in the club. Anyway, after that, I was like, I'm never drinking again. I stopped drinking for a couple of years. We're at Justin's, blah blah blah, and then after the party at Justin's ended, everyone's like, yo, there's an after party down the block at Club Cheetah, and that's where I saw the most miraculous thing in my life.
Oh shit,
Derek Jeter, just come in.
Yo,
not even in the club more than 2 minutes.
Yo.
Whispered to Shorty, I'm Derek Jeter, let's get out of here.
Yo, let's go.
And they left.
You know what I'm saying? And then he went from Club Cheetah, Club Amnesia.
Right? nothing but respect for my captain.
He's
right
now, he's like, Dublin.
Right now he's in Florida. Like, why are you making it hot? While his wife, because his wife is over the age that she probably listens to this podcast. Let's keep it funky. His wife was like, I want to say like 14, 15, 16, 17, 18,
19. Yeah, he's sick.
No, she's really young. I think she's like 20 something.
Yeah.
I think. Y'all don't know Justin's was a restaurant owned by Diddy, okay? P. Diddy's restaurant. Then they still got Justin's in other states, I believe. But that was the one in New York, and that one, you know, it was on a strip. It was on a strip where there was like other stores and other nightclubs and stuff. And then people was like, get them out of here. We don't want these things here. And they're just shut the fuck up.
Yeah, and it was wild because a lot of, like, people used to congregate in front of that shit. Like, it was weird. Yo, I remember going there and this ended up being on a Smack DVD. Jay Mills was battling Sire Castro in front of Justin's.
Whoa, that's some real hip-hop name there.
Yo, that is the most washedest. Yo, go YouTube that shit, yo. If you don't know, go YouTube that shit. You know what I'm saying? Oof. It was super. I was just like, man. And I think Cy Cash was from the Bronx. So I was like pulling for him, but I don't think it went. I don't think it went his way.
Oh, Derek Jeter's wife is. She was born in 1990, so she's 30. You know, he's good. He's all right. It's all right. It's Derek Jeter. He has 27 rings. He's loud. He's loud, bro. He almost died trying to catch a foul ball. Okay?
That's right.
Respect my man. Respect, you know, in the old stadium, not the new stadium.
Respect his name.
Not the new social justice warrior stadium, huh? Huh? Where you guys can snitch on other people just enjoying the game using your text message?
Yeah.
You think George Steinbrenner would have liked that? Huh?
We're supposed to throw peanuts at Red Sox fans, dog. That's tradition.
That is true.
You know what I'm saying? You're not supposed to
snitch. I once saw someone throw, remember when they used to sell, it was a bag of peanuts, but they weren't loose and wrapped in the bag. It was like a plastic bag sealed with peanuts.
With the shells. Yeah.
And this guy threw it and it hit this lady right in the face. And the way it happened was because her husband was being obnoxious because he came, it wasn't even a Red Sox Yankee game. It was the Red Sox, it was the Yankees were playing Toronto because, what was his name? He's really good and he was on Toronto before, he was with there when AJ Burnett was on there. Roy Halladay, there you go. Roy Halladay was pitching. And so it's Toronto versus the Yankees. You and your wife show up in Red Sox jerseys at Yankee Stadium. What do you think is going to happen? You think we're just going to sit there and take that? You get shit thrown at you. So it started with like mustard packets. And then the guy stands up and is like, stop throwing shit at us. Which notifies everyone else that's sitting around him that didn't see things were being thrown at him. Now we have a new game at the stadium. We are no longer watching that stupid game on the Jumbotron where you have to find the Yankee logo underneath the hats as they move around really fast. Now we're throwing shit at niggas. All right? So,
you know, yeah, right.
Good times. Good times in Yankee Stadium.
Can't wait to go back.
Oh, can't wait, bro. Listen, Yankee Stadium is different. Yankee Stadium. It's like when Cliff Lee, he was at Yankee Stadium after wasting the Yankees' time all season talking about maybe I'll come sign with y'all.
Maybe.
And then at the last minute, he's like, yo, fuck y'all. I would never sign with y'all. Y'all suck as a team, as an organization.
Fuck you.
And then when your wife came to the stadium, spit on your wife.
Yo. You know, it's that Staten Island cop that did it too.
Listen, they were like, that's why when the last playoffs, and they were just like, one of the drivers, like an Uber driver or something, and the Yankee fans were like, Uber driver, and it was like classless Yankee fans. I was like, Yankee fans have physically assaulted people as a group.
Like, come on.
You know? Like, come on. Come on, man. Like,
let's be real.
They only play Cotton Eye Joe to keep us calm. Okay?
Word.
Where did you come from? Where did you go?
It's just to confuse us. Like, wow, what? They're Swedish, but they're rednecks?
It's like in zombie movies when they fire fireworks in the air to distract the zombies.
Yeah.
That's all it is.
Exactly.
It is. You play a little Cotton Eye Joe, and then every girl in Yankee Stadium wearing Uggs and black tights looks up in the air. Yeah, like,
what's
bro.
What's going on? Brad, what is that?
Then they do the savage dance. Like, oh. But because Yankee fans are different now, their boyfriend does a savage dance with them. Like, oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. And they do the swipe reveal thing where they switch clothes.
TikTok, real TikTok. Yeah. Yo, free Aunt Becky. You heard? Free Aunt Becky to the backwards.
Free the homie.
Free the homie. She ain't doing nothing. Except lie on the stand. But yo, who gets a 2-month jail, like in prison? Say, it's not even prison. It's jail.
She's like, gonna get out soon.
Yeah, she's not gonna actually go to jail. Man, get the fuck out of here. This ain't Orange is the New Black, B. Like, Shorty's gonna be like, she's gonna go to court. Like, the judge is gonna be like, we're so sorry to inconvenience you. Like, just go back home. You're all right. You suffered enough.
Listen, we're talking about real TikTok. You want to talk real TikTok? Let's shout out some original old school TikTokers. You know what I'm saying? All you new school people.
Hit it.
Y'all want to listen to all these new TikTokers. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? New dances. Where was y'all back in the day, all right? Huh? All my real TikTokers. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Charlie D'Amelio. Okay,
ooh,
out there, yo, shout out to her. Born in May 2004, making that That's money. Right. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Ah,
five, 51 million followers. Ah, you know it.
Your favorite. Shit.
What about Lauren Gray? She's the Rakim of TikTok, I believe. She has 42 million followers and she charges $42,000 a post. Shit.
Yo.
Wow, we might need TikTok. God damn.
Fam,
I'm
about to go to DR and come back like with a fat ass and some titties and just like go on TikTok and just make this bread.
Is that the where we're going? Is Bodega Boys? Are we going from Bodega Boys to Bodega Brazilian Butt Lift Boys?
You know what I'm saying? Butt Lift Boys. Yes.
Yeah,
you know
Butt Lift Boys. Like, y'all.
Clap the cheeks. Yeah.
Original account deleted at 5 million.
Yo,
okay. All right.
They hating,
okay.
But we still getting shmoney. Fuck out of here. We on got mad, time.
We just got mad photos on planes, even though it's a pandemic. It's like, what? Where you going? Where you going? Like, yo. Yo.
We got the mask over our eyes like a sleeping mask.
Not doing it right. We wearing a mask, but we being sexy at the same time and shit. Like,
yo, the mask is over our nipples and shit. Like.
Yeah, like, ah, you guys want to see this? You guys want to see this? Connect to my OnlyFans. Stop being cheap. Stop being cheap.
This is a 10-second clip. There's more where that came from.
We start getting really sucio, and we take the 10-second clip, and we loop it over 20 times. So now it's a 2-minute clip, and we post it on Pornhub to make everyone upset. Ooh. Ooh. Everyone's like, yo, Jesus, that hit a little too close to home.
Yo! Yo, nah. But wait, so fan cams, I'm watched. Fan cams and TikToks are not are mutually exclusive, or can they be done on both platforms? Can you do a fan cam on a TikTok?
Yeah. You can do a fan cam on TikTok. Right. Fan cams aren't exclusive to TikTok because you can also do fan cams on Twitter, but I think most Twitter fan cams were created on TikTok or created on an app to create fan cams.
Do that.
But listen, shout out to everyone that's made like little cheesy Desus and Mero fan cams. We appreciate
them. We appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Thank you.
just jamming up the internet with content.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, shout out to the king of fan cams, though, BTS, though, because y'all motherfuckers destroyed YouTube!
You know
they get, like,
vibes.
Fucking, like, 500 million views in 15 minutes or some wild shit like that. Yo, I might start fucking with K-pop, like, in earnest. Not, like,
K-pop,
you know what I'm saying?
Check out, if you're gonna listen to J-pop, to K-pop, y'all check out BTS, check out Twice, and... The other one was Blackpink. Check them out. They bring the heat. They
one
got a
word?
Joint with Blackpink. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They're South Korean. They bring the heat.
Okay.
You know
shout out to South Korea. Korea. Yo, that reminded me of there was this old hip hop group. This is also watched. I think they were called the Teriyaki Boys, which.
Yes. I do remember them.
Yes. And they shouted out like every Asian country at the end of like one of their songs and shit, like a roll call. And then, like, I just remember the last country they shouted out was, they just said, Korea, and it had, like, the wild, like, echo fade out. I don't know why I remember that.
Hold on a second. Because I'm trying to remember the name of the, they had the drift. Tokyo Drift. Yeah, bro.
Tokyo Drift, yeah.
From Yokohama. Uh-huh. And they did work with Daft Punk and stuff.
Oh, shit.
Hold on, wait.
They're the OGs? And... Are they the Rakims?
No, the original OGs of K-pop, J-pop, and any type of Asian hip-hop of all time, it goes to, this is old school hip, this is hip-hop for real, this is meme hip-hop. If you were really on the internet, you remember a little thing called, a group called Asian Pride, and their number one song, Got Rice, Bitch, okay?
Yo!
AZN Pride, shout out to them,
Pride,
okay?
Yo,
Asian Pride out
pick
here.
Up, pick up.
That's
yo,
it. That, that's
yo,
that's
if you was
it.
Asian and you had AOL Instant Messenger, you had that you, shit in your hand.
You had that shit banging. You had that shit banging.
In all caps. Right. Alternating.
I saw an article today about the most disgusting food in every state. Mm-hmm. And apparently, and I know for a fact you've never had this, but I have to put this on your radar. Have you ever had a New Jersey Sloppy Joe?
No. What's that?
Okay, first of all, I was like, you can't just take Sloppy Joe and be like, all right, it's different because it's New Jersey. Like, you got to give me more of an explanation.
What's the difference?
Listen.
It has gabagool on it? Like, what?
In parts of northern New Jersey, let's start there.
Okay.
A Sloppy Joe is a cold delicatessen sandwich. There are minor variations depending on the deli, but it's always a double-decker thin-sliced rye bread sandwich made with one or more types of sliced deli meat, such as turkey, ham, pastrami, corned beef, roast beef, and sliced beef tongue. Wait. Along with Swiss cheese, coleslaw, and Russian dressing, all in one.
Oh, that's like the kosher. That's like the Cat's Deli flow. That's what is it? What do they call it? A what?
New Jersey Sloppy Joe.
A New Jersey Sloppy. What?
Oh, you're right. They're saying it's very popular in Jewish delis. I've never heard of this. Okay.
Yeah, that's kosher nosh flow. Yeah, all hell right. Yeah. I thought you were gonna hit me with the Jersey version of the bacon, egg, and cheese, which is the Taylor ham. Instead of bacon, they use the Taylor ham.
Taylor ham, Wiz Khalifa's ham, you know.
Yeah. Taylor ham.
Taylor ham, man.
T-H-O-D, cuz.
Ham City, bitch. Ham City, bitch. You're like, what? What? We interviewed Taylor. We interviewed Wiz Khalifa. I'm like, so how did you get into ham production? Like,
he's like, ham and yellow, ham and yellow, ham and yellow, ham and yellow.
You know what it is. It's just mad. It's mad pigs in the background twerking like ham and yellow, ham and yellow.
Yellow, ham and yellow. I feel like it would be remiss if we did not. I feel like we talk about it all the time. People know, like, they just want to like hear it. I feel like people want to hear the sorrow in our voices when we acknowledge that the Knicks got the 8th pick in the draft, but like, there's no sorrow in our voices. Like,
I mean,
do you hear it?
There's literally like, a pandemic going on. Like,
yeah, like, is it that serious?
Who gives a shit about that? That's
you know what I'm saying? Like there's more important things to worry about. Like, I can only buy two things of Lysol at once.
There you go. Saying? Or that Whole Foods in Harlem is still limited in how much nut butter a brother could buy.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what? I've never used nut butter. But it's just like, now that they're saying I can't buy the nut butter, now I'm just like, whoa, 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 I thought this was America. Like, yo, who are you to, like, take my freedom away?
Yo, let's do this. Let's make, like an aftershave for your balls. Call it nut butter, throw it on Amazon, or like Chewy or Soap, like one of them big ass like supermarket websites, and just fuck up the whole search engine shit and just have mad people buying, like, you know what I'm saying, dick moisturizer.
Instead, I'm way ahead of you.
Sandwich spread.
Next Saturday, using this to announce it, we are having the Bodega QAnon. We're having our first protest march in front of the Whole Foods in Harlem. Go in front of the Whole Foods in your state. Yep. And bring a sign that says free the nut butter. Free okay? Nut butter. Everywhere you go. This is our organization now. We, the same way QAnon is trying to free the children and stop pedophiles, we are freeing nut butter. We're freeing butter. All the nuts. Free all the nuts. Free all the nuts.
Free
all the nuts.
Free the nuts. Go.
Let the nuts hang.
Let
free
us
the
nut.
Nuts.
Let us nut.
All right.
Let us
let
nut.
Us nut. Let, there we go. Not. Just all right. The nut on Mars, the nut on Mark Washington. All right,
Washington.
This mad people nutting into the reflective pool. It's like Listen, we didn't nut on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock nutted on us. They're like, yeah. Tell them.
After like 40 nights, it should look like a koi pond.
After it solidifies, it just looks like a white airhead. Like, yeah.
Yo.
You put your finger in it, you're like, bro. It's mystery flavor.
Yo. Oh, yeah. I love it. I can't guess what it is. I think it's Julio.
I'm going to need a little more to get the real mouthfeel, if you know what I'm saying, bro.
Yo, I don't have the patience or fortitude to do this, but I wonder what would happen if you jerked off into a koi pond. Would they eat it?
Probably.
Right?
Probably, and then you feel bad.
I mean,
because you would remember the specific koi that ate your nut. You'd be like, wow. You would. That's something. Because he. What if he
orange spot on your eye?
What if he gobbles it down and then winks at you? How are you gonna feel?
Yo, what if he gobbles it down and just like does it like a little bubble and like rubs it on his chin? Like
He's like yum yum yum. Mm.
Yum. Mm. And then I'm doing the BTS in the hotel room with the koi.
The koi.
We're
eats,
showering together.
The koi eats it and the koi is like, "Thank you, daddy." And you're like, yo. Now it's turning into Moonlight Koi Edition. You want that?
Bro, naughty America.
Nobody does it like naughty.
Koi better.
It's just the last one's like a fish, like. Me and my fish stepdaughter. It's like, no.
It doesn't work like that.
Oh.
That's not how any of this works.
Ugh. This thing is the weirdest food from every state. So that's where I found out about this New Jersey Sloppy Joe.
Yeah, it's wild because Florida's is this meth, if you look closely.
Yeah. Florida is Gator Tail. Seattle is Geoduck. Yo, y'all wilding out there. That's disgusting. Rocky Mountain Oysters is nasty because those are nuts.
A lot of these, I'm like, yo, these sound wild fake. I'm like, Geoduck in Seattle? I thought, like, I just drank mad coffee and rainwater.
But like, no, this is, like, the weirdest. Like, have you seen a Geoduck before?
Yes. It's like a clam with a dick.
Yeah, that's why it's weird. It's like, yo, like, oh, it's Missouri with the meth. Damn, is Missouri adding meth to ingredients like parsley? Are they, like, on a plate?
It's like fucking cilantro.
You're like, here. Yeah. Here you go. There's like just a skimmage of it.
It's a little sprinkle of meth.
That's a treat. A little meth.
A little blue magic.
Actually, no, in Missouri, when you leave, you know how, like, when they bring you the receipt and the bill from back in the days when you used to go to restaurants? Instead of bringing you, like, an after-dinner mint, they bring you a little meth.
A little meth. You know what I'm saying? And a little pipe.
A little palate cleanser. Oh, wow. Oh, thank you. Wow.
Instead of the toothpick and the mint, it's a pipe and a rock. Like, yo, here you go. Here's some glass.
And so then you just take, like, the hand wipe and just, like, start wiping your face furiously. Like, get it clean.
I gotta take my eyeball out with this fork.
Oh. That eyeball snitched on me, bro. This eyeball saw all the bad shit we did.
He saw everything.
Gotta take it out, bro.
I gotta get him out of here.
Get these eyeballs out. Bro, what are you doing? You gonna take your eyeball out? Bro, if you take out your own eyeball, that's crazy. But if I take out your eyeball, that makes sense. Come on, Bodega Boys.
Totally. Yeah,
so
of course.
It's just like, you know, it's cool. Yeah, like, yeah. Should we call Victor and ask him if we should do this? Or just go ahead. Like,
yeah. Like,
we'll be fine. Right, let's go ahead.
Yeah, we'll call, you know, we'll call him later. Leave a voicemail.
And then Kesh calls us the next day, like, I hope you guys are ready for the interview tomorrow. We're mad late because we can't turn on the Zoom windows because we have no eyes. I was just like,
yo, hold on, like, a second. Hold on, like, a second.
God, like, I think I typed in the Zoom ID.
Yo.
It's just straight gibberish on the screen. Yo. Like, they're like, Desus, you,
down. Like, yo.
They're like, Desus, you typed in HGHHHHHJK semicolon, semicolon, semicolon. Zoom IDs have numbers. I was like, sorry. Let me try it. Just hear mad shit falling apart in the back.
They're like, Mero, why do you just keep sending us voice notes of your children shrieking? Why is that?
Hey guys,
what?
Guys, you think we could do the show without me turning my camera on, or is that, like, a big deal?
Like, can we do the show with sunglasses on? How about, like,
yeah, that
cool
work. That would
look. That'd be a cool look.
Also, like, could you send someone to my house to find my sunglasses? Because yeah,
I need
it's really dark in here.
My sunglasses aren't charging properly. I don't know what's wrong. Yeah. I think I have the wrong cable.
Yeah, the thing that happened with Miro's mixer last week is it's happening with my retinas. It's so weird.
Yeah, like, it's wild. It's like they work and they don't.
I rebooted them, but I don't know. Negri, do you have some new ones? Some new retinas for me? Like,
I got some. Let me check in the office. I think I got some Rabindidi's old retinas from the retina. I'm gonna send them over to you. Let's see if they work.
They just and then Chief just drops them off. They don't get installed or nothing. He's just in the back. He's like, here you go.
Yo, you retinas, my nigga.
It's like, oh, thanks. Just get the wild email at night. Like, remember, call time tomorrow's at 11. Please install your retinas. I was like, fuck, I gotta do the green screen and the retinas.
You and Dave, like, can you, like, strafe your retina, like, half an inch to the right?
Can you share your screen? All right.
Just split the difference?
Just take the scalpel and you want to cut it just a little bit. Ooh. Hold on. You know, Elena, are you seeing that? You seeing that? Yeah.
You know what? Can you FaceTime me with me real quick? Let's get through this real fast and
Desus will be right back with you. I just got the scalpel to my eye. Like, all right, cool.
All right, cool.
Give me a second.
Mero, go ahead and start streaming.
I already made the initial incision, so it's like bleeding out. So y'all wanna get back to me?
No, hurry. Yeah. Oh shit. I can't see, but I can see. God damn.
Oh, y'all need a clap. I got the scalpel. I can't.
Is that blood dripping on the mic?
Is that what?
Guys, sorry, guys. Is that a? I hear liquid on the microphone. Is that a? Is that a?
Yeah, that's
that
my. Blood? Yeah, that's my. That's my plasma. That's my. It's my plasma. It's dripping out. Like, can we?
All right. Well, we'll work. It's all right. We'll work around it. You know. Are you comfortable? Are you comfortable? Everything's good.
You just hear somebody like,
Jesus, can you share your OBS screen? We have to change your plasma settings.
I'm like, oh, come on, bro.
Plasma settings?
Come on, bro. Oh, that's the problem. He had too much hemoglobin going on. You're like, oh, wow.
Yo. Yo, I don't remember where I heard this, but it was like science people talking. It wasn't like, you know, like some bullshit talk show. And they were talking about people regularly living to be 200 within the next like few generations or some shit like that, like talking about medical advances and shit like that. And I was just like, I was like, I don't know if I want to live to be 200. Like, if I would have known, like, I probably would have got married like around 150, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I not mean, 27 right now. Ain't nobody trying to live to 200. Right, 2020 is the final board for humans. And I'm sorry, I'm not being dramatic. People are like, only in America. No, not only in America. America, do you understand? There are two tropical storms developing into hurricanes that are about to hit America at the same time and in the same location. That has not happened in quite some time. At this point, Mother Nature is like, yo, fuck y'all. America, you're done. America, y'all are doing too much. We get you out the paint.
This is nerdy fat god Victor coming in, but you know what today is?
Earth Day?
No, the total opposite. It's actually Overshoot Day. It's the day that humanity has given off more emissions than the Earth can naturally offset.
Ooh, offset!
We do about 160. We've had an Overshoot Day since the 1950s.
Oh, wow.
But 1950s, now that makes it better. Niggas was smoking coal.
Yeah,
like they were powering.
This makes it better because now when you find out people live. Now that you find out people live longer, you always hear about people like, "Oh, this person lived to 95. Oh, this person died at 106." And now you're just like, you know what? Fuck that. You know what? You live mad long, but we're living in probably the most lit part of humanity.
Yeah.
Think about it. If we don't get out of this, this is where it ends. And future aliens are going to be like, yo, them last niggas was real niggas.
Yeah.
Them last niggas. Yo, we bang with them. Yo, shout out to the human. They're going to wear throwback jerseys and throwback NASCAR jackets of us. And they'll be like, yo, New York, 2020. They survived. Yo. The defibrillators. Yo, the Cuomos. They're going to... Basically, alien TikTok is just going to be alien kids doing tribute to the wiped out civilization that was humanity. And so like they're gonna be like little alien girls dancing like JoJo Siwa and all that shit. Yeah. They're gonna make like an alien Thomas the Tank Engine.
Renegade.
And you know, there's gonna be alien TikToks of little alien kids doing suck my dick from the back, doing shit from the show, all of that. So to our future aliens, we welcome you. Thank you. Please use our memories.
You know what I'm saying?
The aliens are going to be like, yurr. They're going, yeah. What does that mean? Humans use that.
It means affirmative. Everything. Chopped cheese was a name they gave their children.
We'd be like, oh, that's not.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Ooh, some of the MP3 files got corrupted. Like, no, MP3 files are not going to be all together, so they're going to just hear, they're just going to hear, like, static and hear, like, different parts, and they'll be like,
their real names was Mr. Fun Fun and Benzo the Clown.
Like, yes, that is correct.
When they weren't making the podcast and making Showtime, they used to host private children's parties where the adults weren't allowed, and they would rush out if adults came in.
And we're like, no,
that is correct.
The one that calls himself the Kid Mero started every show by running over a canine.
He's like, what?
Why would he do that?
Why would he do that?
Also, they talk about eating ass quite a lot. Do they mean ass as in slang for buttocks or mirror? We shall decide.
We have to do some forensic testing. Also, apparently, Jesus lives in a fridge because he always says, baking sodas, it's me, Sonny D. We wish he had more money. He should not be living in a fridge. He's a grown man.
He's a grown adult. How does he fit? What are the dimensions of the refrigeration package?
Shut up. Oh, man. Shout out to the aliens.
Aliens are mad corny. Imagine aliens are mad swaggerless.
Are we doing this?
Like,
are we doing this?
Yes.
Are aliens we doing this? We doing it? Yo, fuck aliens.
Yeah. Yo, aliens, imagine the aliens come down and they're just like all Cory Booker. Like, it's like, hey guys.
Hi guys. I came to your universe because my girlfriend told me to do it. You're like, yeah. Oh, wow.
My girlfriend that I love. Hey guys, would you like to play a game, a match of round ball? I've studied it extensively on my brainstem modulator.
I come from the planet Brick, which is made of, you know, bricks. But the problem is Cory Booker is kind of big. So if say we did something and it's like the Cory Booker aliens, like they come over here. Remember, Cory Booker, we roasted him, but he's super polite, super nice, super jovial.
And he's also 6'5".
Right. So what if like the aliens come and they're super nice, super polite, super jovial, and then we're just like, no, fuck out of here, suck my dick. And they're like, oh, so I traveled 50 light years and you told me to suck your dick.
Wow, okay. Well, keep that same energy when I grow my 16 arms and pummel the shit out of you.
It's like, shit.
It's into Goro shit from Mortal Kombat. Yep. Like, oh, shit.
I'm like, oh, shit. Someone get Rosario Dawson. Go get Rosario. Hey. Oh, man.
Rosario, call Bernie. Call Bernie Sanders. He knows where she's at.
It's only as us like battling Cory Booker as if he's Thanos and shit. We gotta we have to get every group we've ever worked with to help us. It's just like, yo, Haim is over there. You got Ezra and Rashida over here. Everyone from the Bodega universe is coming together to help us defeat Cory Booker. Is Anna Kendrick shows up? I'm like, yes, Anna's here. Yo. Yeah. Yeah.
Beo flying with a web that's like just a hookah hose. Like, yo.
I'm like, oh shit.
What's up, my nigga? I'm here.
Tommy just shows up like, you guys ready for dinner? I'm like, yeah, Tommy. Everyone in the movie theater is cheering. Like, Tommy, oh my God, no. Tommy, no.
Like, yo, then it just goes mad quiet for 1 second. And it's just like, whoosh. And you see like the wild meatball sub fly across the screen and fly into somebody's hand, pan out, big time Tommy.
Yo, the crowd's like, whoa, are you guys fucking saying Tommy?
Oh,
he's like,
God,
he flies in, he's like, take it easy. You're like, oh shit, oh shit. There's like more people coming out. You start seeing Jay Ellis.
To the old school.
You see Jay Ellis over there, Issa Rae over there. You just hear like a wow, woo, and then someone flies in and like slams into the ground. And it's just Bamani on a knee. Like, oh, I'm like, oh shit, let's go. I'm like, everyone from the Bodega Hive is here.
Yeah.
And we look around, and I'm like, Mero, you think we're ready? And you're about to say like yes, and they're like, wait. And then you just hear the crowd, someone in the back of the theater is like, oh shit, no, it's her.
Oh, shit. Oh my
and
God.
You just see, instead of Captain Marvel, it was AOC. Nigga.
Like, yeah, she's like,
oh shit, AOC, yo! Bodega Hive, assemble!
Oh, the hive is like red and she goes full Bronx. She's like, yeah, I'm gonna fuck y'all up.
Let's go! Listen, let's make this movie. Let's fucking make this movie.
Let's do it.
It's like a week later, they're like, this movie bombed. No one got the references. It's made for a very niche podcast. Why would you release it in China? Everyone in China is like, who is AOC?
Who is
AOC? Why are they, who's Desus Mero? Why are they following them?
I don't know.
Who's the guy with the meatball? Was that, is he the president of America?
Is he looks big. He must be, is he?
I don't know.
He's got to be, is that Donald Trump? Did he shave?
But Anna Kendrick was in there. I loved her. In
oh,
movie.
I loved her.
She's,
yeah.
She's big out here. Did you see her Disney Plus movie?
Oh, it's so good.
So good. Shout out to Anna Kendrick. Shout out to Bodega Hive. And shout out to episode 216. Which, I mean, I don't have to break down the math to you, but 216 just like 200 plus 16. I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
No, listen.
You know what I'm saying? No more. Yo, shh.
Listen, I don't want to be that guy, but like Foxy Brown was my math tutor, so you know I'm good with that shit. Like, I'm just Yo, it's your boy Desus Nice. Young Chipotle, aka Pocket Stay Fat Like Teary Up. AKA Pocket Stay Fat Like, here we go. Stubborn, I might know you, bitch. Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, Desus H. Fuego. Mr. Nando's with a Rondo, and I'm not socially distancing because I don't care about other people. Now, come on over here, you proper bird, innit? Mio never said the Noveta Ecuador in Nueva York. Mikel going off the Juve boss. still going to an illegal Juve because I'm the Juve boss. I have to.
Yeah, you know? Like, this is the boss.
If I listen,
the job. If you go to your job and you're like, yo, where's the boss?
Imagine you like home. Imagine you like in the mafia. You a mob hitman. And they're like, yo, go whack Salvador Salami over there in a country club in the Bronx. And you're like, whoa, it's a pandemic.
Whoa, he's a boss.
I can't. Not even that. It's not even the boss. I'm quarantined. I haven't left my apartment in 4 months.
Come on.
I get all my food through Amazon Prime. I'm not going to break the bubble. You go wild? To go murder?
I just whack FedEx guys every once in a while to keep my gun warm.
I literally just wiped down my... I just Clorox wiped my doorknob. I'm not taking any chances out here. Yeah, the people that get the corona, you know, they say they survive, but you know what it does to your lungs when you survive? I can't take that risk. I got at least 40, 50 more years of whacking people. Okay, you know, I gotta be careful.
Doing a hit in mad PPE.
Yeah. You trying to sneak up on someone in a bunny suit, they just hear...
Like, yeah, they're like, shh.
You can't aim. You can't aim because you got sunglasses and the face mask and it's making the sunglasses fog up. I can't see. Damn. I can't see. The is that
fabric,
you?
The little fabric booties got you sliding all over the fucking floor and shit. Like, yeah.
Also, you shoot four people for the wrong reasons because they got masks on and you thought there was a person you were supposed to shoot. You're like, oh shit. Shot the wrong one again.
Ooh,
fuck.
My bad. This mask thing is really tough. Can I get eye colors next time?
Yeah, we got to find a new system. This is not working.
Yeah, it's not working.
Yo, MC Lookagoonga P putting up for 40. MC Lookagoonga P putting up for 40 with your shorty. AKA, don't talk to me in the open pool. I don't know you. The original plus one got plus one, so don't make a fuss, son. DJ Rossi and the Jamaican Jew. Jermaine Avocado Toast. Pa, the ghost of Mufasa. Young Chakuni without the coonery. AKA, Chili Moan, left handed reliever for the Yankees. K-L-O-K.
Happy, we here.
Two Phone Jones. Dizek Machina. Actually, with Chili Moan, I remember one of the stories was they were playing against the Mets, and the game got canceled the same way the game got canceled here, but because of bad cocaine.
Yes. So
it was right.
They cut it with Kame instead of Ajax.
Yeah, bro. Daryl Strawberry is so tight about it, bro. It was a lot. Listen, bro. You know what it is. It is Two Phone Jones, D-Zek Machina, Jake Chuckles, Stanley Cups, the human Dr. Bonner's label, Dalut, DNR de Chapio, Mr. 240p, because I got my Pinot Blurry. DJ Woolite, you're listening to Washed FM. Up next, in honor of Texas, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're going to shout out the man whose number is 281-330-8004. Shout out to Mike Jones.
Mike
Jones.
Mike
Texas.
Jones.
Holding it down on our last show. You know what I'm saying? Texas out there. OKC out there. Palo Alto. San Antonio. All good places.
Austin. Dallas. San Antonio.
Yo, shout out to y'all for coming out. It was a live show.
You know what I'm saying?
Yo, the Curry Gold, DJ Spicer, Jamal Hashburn, the Bronx Lean, Dion Ray, and Nephew's Nephew, the Moreno, You Cannot Contain-O, no. The Human Mermaid, Word to Ja, Young Aaron, the Racist Provocateur, Hedrick Bloodcross, Nelson Bandela, Sergio Can't See Me, Vladimir Buffett, the Human World is Melting in Your Mouth, Mr. Bex on Tekkerton, Ricky Tiki Squadby, Greg Popovich, More Says with Your Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maccabee, but I got that cucumber, the juice of the press, which your boy never is. Yeah. I am the art, damn it. The Dundada Ganoush, the Moral Cup of Noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fashion Over Casanova, where you make cents, 5 cents, 10 cents, dollar.
What you need?
Listen. I don't think I made it clear.
Where you are? What you need? Tell them one time.
Forget the small change. Give me big money wine. Thank you. The only other one I salute is Dipset. Mr. Sagger, catch me at square one, top left, because man's is Marv. Also, if you see Tory Lanez, there's a bounty on his head, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
All right. I talk to my cousins, Mr. Sagger. True Rizzuto, holy cow. Mr. Star Punk, because all I do is count checks and jerk off. We got OJ, Purple Stuff Soda, and it's me, Sunny D.
That's right.
David Yerman, these expensive, these red bottoms, these bloody shoes. Smokey Noah, Andrew Kunana, a.k.a. the Junior, Energy God Junior, comes down, Bobby Chaja.
Sit on it.
Like a USB stick, take it out and put it back in. You put it in the wrong way. Call me Petco because I got your bitch on freeze. Shout out to the top. Shout out to Gossip of Sayas. Shout out to the topic of Gossip and Sayas. Shout out to the 11791. Bro, you can't sit in that seat. That's a social distancing seat right there on the LIWR. All right. Let me see your peak ticket, bro. Yeah, you know the vibes. AKA Grandpa Joe, because when you see Charlie, you see me. Don't touch that golden ticket because he's going to crash you, okay? Mm-hmm. Also, if you're pregnant, don't change the kitty litter because then you can get like a very bad disease that pregnant women get when they change the cleaning litter. So don't do that. Don't Yo, do it's that your shit. Man Deadeye Desus. Morning, Sheriff. Be a be ashamed if someone took something out of the cart for someone who was online shopping. It's not the same, but it feels good. I'm going through it.
Great.
I'm losing my mental health. I'm losing my mental health right now in a pandemic. As someone who likes to steal from physical locations, there's no physical locations to steal from.
It's so hard.
You know, it's hard out here for a thief. So
still cattle and rustling.
Just the other day, I pretended to steal a city bike, but I really just paid for it. So, you know.
Didn't feel right.
Just keep me in your prayers. Mr. Shopping that street, easy, a bad breeze like I'm easy. Please believe me. A black Asian addict who crack your back like an automatic craft medic. Miss Lamarino, Mesh Marino, a fresh marina, a cold demeanor, the sheet mask killer. No one could be iller. The black like Morris, support Morris, young KPI. Yeah, it's your personal Jesus. The Pele of Peloton. Check out that app. Check out Tunde's Afro Beats ride. That shit's slamming. Oh, shit. AKA your problematic bae. Listen, it's not a secret family if you've already in your heart given up on them.
That's right. If you have abandoned them completely, emotionally. You are no longer beholden.
Listen, if you're there, but you're not there. Up next, coming to the stage, we've got...
It's your boy. It's your boy. The Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Durag, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, a.k.a. Tris Khalifa! A.k.a. Skirt Loader, jump the curb, hit your dog. Keep it moving, ask me if I give a fuck. I have my mask on, he did not. You know what I'm saying? I don't fucking baby, I fucking man. You know what I'm saying? AKA, no need to check the guest list because there is no guest list because everything is virtual now, you bozos.
Virtual.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. The people in Sweden probably fucking kissing on the mouth right in the train right now, and y'all had to fuck it up.
God, they're probably just driving around. They're driving around, yeah. Spitting on each other,
yeah.
Doing glory holes,
yeah,
licking each other's faces and shit because they can.
Yeah, just because they can, just to flex. You know what I'm saying? God damn it. A.K.A. CC Dad Bathia, you know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Tiger Backwoods smoking 3 grand blunt to hit you with this 9 iron. A.K.A. get into the shmoney and he smoke as your boy go, man. A.K.A. Mensch Montana, huh? I went from roaches to deers in my backyard. You know, I'm a good guy.
Hey.
A.K.A. Hey, listen, man. I got my kids activated, fully loaded, locked loaded to put a hit out on somebody that I'm not going to name because I don't want to get them indicted. But I'm motherfucking dad of the year, you know what I'm saying? Because it will be charged as mine.
Dad.
You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Ben Smack Biombo, A.K.A. D.A.O. Maradona, A.K.A. Dickie Bebo Tombo, you don't come in this pussy no more. This pussy belongs to me. Actually, it does not. I respect your agency, my queen, and I must have full consent from you, and it must be enthusiastic. Thank you.
Enthusiastic.
AKA, you know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Barlow Santana, so smooth. I small asleep at the wheel and clash the zip code. Yeah, and then I get out and run because cops don't care no more. A.K.A. the Dominican Dandada, A.K.A. Listen, I'm going to swipe my card again. There's definitely money on it. Stop trying to play me.
Call
your manager. You know what I'm saying? That DVR's the show and embarrass you. You know what I'm saying? Don't worry about how fucking smacked I am, dog.
Bro, that's the Kid Mero. That's the Kid Mero. Bro, he has like, bro. Like, yeah. You're really gonna, bro, you're gonna run his card? Yeah. Like, come on, you know he got the mission.
Oh, you wanna
see
him?
He's on Showtime. He's the plantain supernova. You're really gonna embarrass my man like this and check out? Like, let his shit go through, bro.
Yeah, let him know. Let him know.
Bro.
Yeah.
Bro, I've been fucking with the brand since Complex, bro. Thank this is egregious.
I appreciate you, Michael.
Who's this guy?
I appreciate you, Michael.
I mean, bro, you know what? You say die for the hive, so I mean, if you want, like, you were saying
Hi, bro. Brother, you know what I'm saying?
Bro,
maybe off the clock.
Bro, yeah, how you doing, my
name? Hey, you want to take a selfie?
Bro, you want to listen to some new Tory Lanez?
No. AKA Romeo Santos. Tu favorito, mami. So zanny. Let me black out. Yo, I never cared about social distancing, and I still don't, because I'm out here. Yo, you see me eating Shorty's butt after she was in the fire hydrant. You know the vibes, you know what I'm saying? AKA.
I mean, technically, that's clean.
Yeah, it is. Actually, yeah, no, it is. Very clean. You know what I'm saying? AKA. Lightnail Dutchie. Hello. Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. That you are coronified. You know what I'm saying? So that's why we smoking personals until 2025. Fuck out of here. We're not taking no chances. AKA Tom Brady, got my balls more deflated than Bobby Kraft's. You know what I'm saying? We the table child boys. You know what I'm saying? But we are respecting social distancing. So we getting jerk dillsy from 6 feet away. You know what I'm saying? They're using the little grabby things that they use to get shit on the high shelf. You know what I'm saying? It can't feel the ass Tyson. You know what I'm saying? I won't explore your costumes. Not consensually, of course. We the consent boys. A.K.A. Lil Snoozy Fur. First nigga to tap out on live. Bit social distancing before that Rona. A.K.A. Final Messi MVP of Gelato. A.K.A. Xander Benefield. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna get some sticks. A.K.A. Woo, Joe Hookah. I dare you.
To what?
To smoke with me.
I need a location.
At Mama Sushi. Ooh. I'll drop a pin so you can meet me. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Ben Barson. My hands are gifted.
Thumbs up.
I've officially given up on government and have started doing surgery again. So now I can flex on you motherfuckers and then let you know that I have repaired a digestive tract of a mortally wounded child using only a dad hat and a lollipop from TD Bank that I found in my desk drawer.
I'll make your fave could never.
You know what I'm saying? That's right. Lick it, don't stop. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. I'll be your medicine cabinet because I'm the Zen man. It's gonna be a weed. A.K.A. Rico Sabrosa. A.K.A. Baby New 425. Niggas got garbage down the way. A.K.A. Nino Brown. Shut the Carter down. Got your girl bagging up with her nipples is brown. You know what I'm saying? I like to see them. Yeah. Hershey Kiss nipples. Let me taste them. Yeah. Ooh. A.K.A. Live harassing patrons eating alfresco. It's the East Street Monster DVB doing all his greatest hits like I wanna be the one your DT is fucking. And don't say club. Don't let me lean. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Mate. I might just do a pre-recording of this one because it's like every week I have to tell you blokes that there's only two rock stars left in this world. It's the Bodega Boys, of which I am one. The plantain seed be never in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed of selling PP that I stole from the Dollar Tree. You know what I'm saying?
Boy.
A.K.A. A.K.A. I met Mike Francis. I'm never going to fail. You know what I'm saying? It's the Pope. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. get those bubble buckets, but he's about to take an L to LeBron. God damn you. Hate to see it. It's Carmelo Anthony.
For three.
Bang. Yo, listen. If you see me at Target, higher than Bull Bull at the peak of his vertical, you know what I'm saying? Approach me like an Earth-sized mammal dog, you know what I'm saying? Because we're supposed to be observing social distancing, and there's that little sticker on the floor that has footprints on it. Stand over there, my nigga, before I react like an Earth-sized mammal, and you might not like that. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Tom Petty and the Ball Breakers, you know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Whoa! Hey, kids! It's Benzo the Clown. Hire me for your kid's birthday party. Even though it depends on your comfort level, I can show up in person, or we can do Zoom. my friend Mr. Funfun, though, prefers in-person celebrations.
Hey, kids. Hi, it's Mr. Funfun. Listen, I have a disguise on for legal reasons, but I mean, if any of you kids want to go on, like, a wild adventure, like, you ever seen the magic school bus? Well, like, yeah. It's not like a school bus. It's kind of just like a Prius, and like, whoa, you have to sit on my lap, but you know, it's
cool. Whoa, hey, no, we have the van. okay, thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Rastin. You're not getting your deposit back. We gotta go. It's a family emergency. Bye. So fake lead to your favorite SoundCloud rapper, dog. He is high off of whatever. I peed in a Gatorade bottle, dog. I peed in a Gatorade bottle and I just gave it to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. I am phoning it in so hard right now with the drugs. Like, I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. So when you just listen to your next little whatever the fuck album and he is just talking about piss, you know why. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Oh, shit. This hair is laid. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can't see it, but it is motherfucking laid. God damn. Shit. Looking like a motherfucking...
I'm wearing wigs from now on. I'm living my truth.
Let's go full auntie, B. Let's just rock full wigs auntie all day.
And you notice none of my wigs are turned the right way? So fuck it. It's gonna be lit. There you go. It's the bang. It's the bang. The bang.
The bang. Bang.
The bang. Oh, no.
It's gotta be you, Desus, and Bomani.
Here we go. Bible. Listen.
We're going to call the group the Bayang.
Oh, AKA shit.
A.K.A.
Papi! Oh, turn on your SAP right now! Hasan, tírame la fucking pita! Coño, oye, que lo que vamos a jugar, llegó el instintivo. Coño, espérate, vamos a dar la reversa. Oye, que lo que vamos a jugar. Llegó el instintivo FIFA, coño, más duro todo, más duro, coño, con un mojón de Robocop. You know what I'm saying? Si tú me ves en un city bike dando vueltas por Santiago, tú sabes que lo que es conmigo. You know what I'm saying? Yo lo mandé en un barrel, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Primeramente, no me hablo mucho, loco. Yo, a mí no me gusta dar muchas cotorras y hablar mierda, tú sabes. Yo hablo con las manos, si me entiendes, o con la tabla, mejor. You know what I'm saying? Somos tigres callejeros, no me vengas con vainas raras. You know what I'm saying? Este ha sido Ey, espérate. Que tengo que dar mi shout-out. Shout-out a la casa, Showtime. Shout-out Cash Shop. You know what I'm saying? El que pone los cuartos. You know what I'm saying? Shout-out Hasan Hussein, que pone la fucking nota. Shout-out Desus, buena la nota jamaiquina. You know what I'm saying? Caribeño in the house. You know what I'm saying? El que shout-out Víctor Marte, el papi de la ley 24, quilate de Belén. Hay coco de todo, abocacate de todo. Shout-out a la nena de la bodega, Dai, la más dura, la planta, la insuperable. Vicky, la más loca, top. Pisito de miel, fuego para Celine. Sharon, el presidente Pío, secretario de defensa, tipo con engañado, avísame que lo suelto. Llegó mi hermano friki y no lo va a dejar desde 12 años por no ser boca floja. Yo no cacoro con palomo. Que descanse para mi hermanito Sexor. You know what I'm saying? Y que de. Ey, que de la casa, lávate tus manos, tápate tu cara con tu mascarita. Y a los policías que asesinaron a Brianna Taylor, justicia, demandamos inmediatamente. Gracias.
You heard what Mero said. Let's arrest the killers. The cops that murdered Breonna Taylor. Sadly, you're feeling like you're getting to the point where they actually won't be arrested. But you know what? We're going to keep her name out there. We're going to keep it alive. We're going to keep her honor out there for all the victims of cop violence.
That's right.
And you know what it is? Shout out to Cash App for, Cash App and the Bodega Hive. That's and right. Making this art production possible. You know what I'm saying? Is it? Shout out to Showtime. Still banging Showtime out there. Sundays and Thursdays. Sucio Sundays and Yursdays.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Be sure to, you know what I'm saying, bro? Don't be afraid. If at 4 a.m. you want to text message one of us, hit us up at 917-540-8971. No dick pics, please.
No,
unless that's how you're feeling, bro.
Unless that's how you feel. You know what I'm saying?
You never know.
We love all y'all. You know what I'm saying?
All I'm saying is Victor. Victor checks all the messages, bro. So, you know, whatever you see, whenever you send, he sees first.
You know what I'm saying?
You know.
So, if you got a bra like Brajol.
Send it over, bro. he's been working for the weekends like usual.
That's right.
But listen.
And also, you need to go to BodegaHive.com right now because that is where you will find all the information for the virtual tour experience. That shit that Kanye was trying to do back in the day, that 8-screen multimedia experience. We're doing it right now.
We pulled it off.
We are the hood.
We are the hood Cirque du Soleil, okay?
That's right.
Cirque du, and then we pronounce it like that. Cirque du Soleil, bro.
Duh.
Okay?
You know what I'm saying?
All right. But episode 216.
Yeah.
All right. Listen, while you enjoy this, maybe pop a, don't be an odd fellow. Pop a lactate. We out.
That's it. That. Ha!